Hello viewers, welcome to my new video for the chapter development class 10 economics. In part 1 we have discussed about few factors relating to development. I hope you must have understood, and those who have not seen it, please see it. Let's continue with the topic, and here we see how to compare the different countries. We have discussed about per capita income in the previous video. For every country, if we standardize with dollars the per capita income of the country, so we'll attain a level where can keep all the countries at par, and it makes the comparison very easy and apt. The point here we talk about is, it is kind of a average only. So averages are not out of the range of errors. So there are some problems with the errors also. That average does not give you the correct picture of the range. That some of the times in mathematics class, you must have seen the class interval range. That means if we talk about, say, the class interval ranging from 0 to 10, if the frequency is 20, it may be that the person who is sitting in the 10th position only, he is having all the items concerning to the universe, say 10. So it will not give you the actual picture that each one of them is having a real amount of the thing. Maybe they all are sitting vacant and only the last one is having the money. It's same thing occurs in society also. A lot of people have a lot of money, but if we divide them by the total population of that area, the per capita income comes out in that way only. So that is just an idea. The average is just a range which does not give you the correct pictures sometimes. So it is a thing that should be kept in mind while using the averages. Let us talk about public facilities. In the previous video also, we had a word regarding this, that public facilities are very, very essential, because only income does not give you the true picture of the country, whether it is developed or not. If the country is not fully equipped with the public facilities as well, the meaning of development becomes very less. In the previous video, I also gave the example of that even the prime minister has to inhale a polluted air if the city is not having clean and pure air. That means all the sanitation or the garbage management should be good enough, and the vehicles should have all the methods and measures so that they reduce pollution, air pollution. So when we get into the topic of development, it is a very, very inclusive topic. It includes all the aspects. Just having money is not a criterion that you will be a happy person or a developed nation also. So we have an example of PDS system. That's an excellent example here in your NCRT book. From class 9, we have been reading this topic, that government announces some presupposed prices, that is your minimum support price, and the farmers give away their, peasant give away their production at a fixed price pre-announced by the government. And then after procuring that amount of grain from the people, the government redistributes it or keeps it for the buffer, that is for the contingencies or the emergencies, and it provides it through ration shops, and it's a very, very reasonable or very, very subsidized rates that they offer for the poor to purchase. And let us talk about sustainability. Sustainability is the most important topic nowadays. And why is it so important? Because having an existent resource, having a technology to utilize it, is today and the current status of development. With the passage of time, if that resource vanishes, say for example the crude oil, if we keep on using it without thinking, definitely in coming years, if say we talk about, who will believe that there were petrol pumps? For example, if there is a thermal power plant and it is using coal, and if also vanishes, then the whole technology becomes a waste and the process of development is hampered. For example, if there is no energy generation or the electricity generation from these power plants, a huge and a massive investment that has been made here is a waste. The number of people employed there, they have to leave the jobs. And all of a sudden, such a huge amount of electricity that will be required by the industry or the domestic usage, from where we will fulfill it. So we should, and we keep these things in mind, then only we are able to achieve sustainable development. That means we keep in mind all the resources to be used properly, judiciously, so that the process of development keeps on going. It does not stop, it does not hamper, and it does not use all the resources which should also be available to the coming generations. The same thing we have discussed in the chapter, Agenda 21, and the summit we have discussed, it's the same topic. And we should not confuse it. They just are the similar topics, but the relation here is on economic terms. And in geography, it talks more of resources, on the availability of resources and the occurrence. So I hope you have understood the second part as well, and you find it easy. Thank you.